Hello friend, now in this video we discuss about method of multipliers. In the video of Lagrange's equations we have seen that how we have an auxiliary equations, and from auxiliary equations how we can find a solution of the differential equations. In this sense, we have the auxiliary equations are dx divided by p equal to dy divided by q equal to dz divided by r. Then suppose L, M and N are, these are constants or functions of x, y, z. We have to choose this L, M, N such that it may be functions of x, y, z or constant, and multiply like this dx divided by p equal to dy divided by q equal to dz divided by r equal to L dx plus M dy plus N dz divided by L p plus M q plus N r. Now these constants L, M, N are chosen so that this L p plus M q plus N r equal to 0. So L, M, N are not any constants or any functions of x, y, z, but we have and restrictions to choose this L, M and N r in a such way that we get L p plus M q plus N r equal to 0. So if denominator is 0, the numerator L dx plus M dy plus N dz is also equal to 0. And then we can easily integrate this relation, and we get a first relation U equal to C1, solution of this equation U equal to C1, solution of these equations. So we have chosen the multipliers L, M and N in a such way that the LP plus MQ plus N are equal to 0. Similarly, we need another pair since the solution of this equation contain U and V. Choose L1, M1 and N1 in a such way that L1P plus M1Q plus N1R equal to 0, and we get L1 into dx plus M1 into dy plus N1 into dz equal to 0. This gives us another relation V equal to C2. Then F of U comma V equal to 0, or V is equal to F of U, is the solution of given differential equations. So this is the method of multipliers. We see examples so that the idea regarding the multipliers will be clear. Let us solve mz minus ny into del z by del x plus nx minus lz into del z by del y equal to ly minus mx. This is my small p, this is my small q. Therefore here the p, capital P equal to mz minus ny, capital Q equal to nx minus lz, and capital R equal to ly minus mx. If we compare this with pp plus qq equal to r. Now from this we write auxiliary equations dx divided by mz minus ny, dy divided by nx minus lz and dz divided by ly minus mx. Now, we take L M N, then you can see that here dx divided by mz minus ny equal to dy divided by nx minus lz equal to dz divided by ly minus mx equal to ldx plus mdy plus n dz divided by l m z minus l n y plus m n x minus m l z plus n l y minus n m x. Now you can see that here l m z plus and l m z minus cancel, l n y and l n y cancel, m n x and m n x cancel, denominator is 0, and denominator is 0, therefore we have l dx plus m dy plus n dz equal to 0. On integrating this we get lx plus m y plus nz equal to integrating constant c. So we get a first multiplier. Okay, now we multiply these equations by, let us multiply, let us write these equations. We choose x, y and z as a multiplier. So that here you can see how we can choose another multipliers, and I'm writing this multipliers here. What is our first relation? Our first relation is lx plus my plus nz equal to 0. This is equal to c1, and this is our first relation. Now we are chosen x, so x into dx plus y into dy plus z into dz divided by multiplying by x, m xz minus xny plus ynx minus ylz plus zly minus zmx. Okay, so you can see zmx and this zmx get cancelled. This is plus and minus get cancelled. This plus and minus get cancelled. And we get x into dx plus y into dy plus z into dz equal to 0. Integrate this, x square divided by 2 plus y square divided by 2 plus z square divided by 2 equal to c2 divided by 2, or x square plus y square plus z square equal to c2. This is our second relation. And hence the solution is f of lx plus my plus nz comma x square plus y square plus z square equal to 0. This is the solution of these equations. Okay, let us take another example. Suppose the problem is solve x into z square minus y square del z by del x plus y into x square minus z square into del z by del y equal to z into y square minus x square. Now we write auxiliary equation directly, dx divided by x square into z square minus x into z square minus y square plus equal to dy divided by y into z x square minus z square and dz divided by z into y square minus x square. Okay, so let us choose multipliers x, y and z. Then you can see that dx divided by x into z square minus y square equal to dy divided by y into x square minus z square equal to dz divided by z into y square minus x square equal to x into dx plus y into dy plus z into dz divided by z into dz divided by, we are multiplying by x, so this is x square into z square minus x square y square plus y square x square minus y square z square plus z square y square minus z square x square. Now you can see z square x square minus and z square x square plus, x square y square minus and x square y square plus, x y square z square minus and y square z square plus. So we get denominator 0. As denominator is 0, x into dx plus y into dy plus z into dz equal to 0. And solution, integrating this, x square divided by 2 plus y square divided by 2 plus z square divided by 2 plus c1 divided by 2 get cancelled and we have x square plus y square plus z square equal to c1. This is our first relation. We write here the first relation plus z square equal to c1. Now to get the second relation, we make a small adjustment and add all these terms. You can see that the denominator term is x, therefore we write that term as like this. This is equal to here dx divided by x plus dy divided by y plus dz divided by z. We have taken this x in the numerator and then what remain in the denominator? Z square minus y square plus x square minus z square plus y square minus x square. Very simple relation, x square get cancelled, y square get cancelled, z square get cancelled and we get 0. So we can see that we get dx divided by x plus dy divided by y plus dz divided by z equal to 0. Integration of this is log of x plus log of y plus log of z equal to log of c2. And this is log of x, y, z equal to log of c2, or x, y, z equal to c2. This is the second relation and hence final solution is f of x, y, z, comma x square plus y square plus z square equal to 0. This is the solution of this differential equations. So friend, I hope you have get the idea how to solve this differential equation by using the method of multipliers. In mathematics, we need a practice. Practice made man perfect, it is known to you. And there is a no technique how to choose multipliers. These idea will be get by a very practice. Therefore, you need to solve number of examples to get idea of this method of multipliers and how we can choose the method of multipliers and get the solution of these differential partial differential equations. So thank you friend, thank you for watching the video.